Force is Game Flunky, and we're back to Tales of Berseria, Part 2. I think last time we left off, we were looking for Lafayette. I think he went into the woods. Before that, we're going to talk to some of the NPCs around town. That way we can get a better understanding, or you can get a better understanding what's happening.
Have you seen Lafayette?
Nope. Can't say that I have.
All right. Let me know the second you see him.
Got it. Is he in bad shape?
Well, he refuses to stay in bed. He needs his rest, but he's always walking around or reading outside.
I can't say I'm surprised. He's always been a curious lad. He likes reading difficult books. When I saw him the other day, he told me all about the latest navigation techniques and exotic farming methods, too.
Smart kid.
Only one kid in a million is as smart as he is.
You're exaggerating. Well, maybe not.
It's a shame. If he could go to school in the capital, I'm sure he'd make a name for himself as a scholar.
The capital? Isn't that days and days by ship from Taliesin? No way. Not happening. Even if he gets better, I could never let him go that far away all by himself.
He can handle it. He's actually a very responsible boy. I don't think you need to worry.
I couldn't handle it. I would worry.
Selfish?
But
hey, just me. All right. If you remember from the previous Let's Play, Lafayette went missing. And now she's going around town looking for her brother.
I was going to have them join the search, but they won't move at all. It's like they're scared of something.
Hey, Velvet, did you hear the news? Tonight is going to be another Scarlet Night.
I remember the moon turned red 7 years ago. But what is it anyway?
It's a red lunar eclipse. It happens every several years or so. Apparently, you can predict the next one by watching the movements of the stars. According to legend, a crimson moon is a gate that connects our world to the next. It's also said to be proof of humanity's sins.
You sure know a lot about it.
Luffy said taught me just a few minutes ago.
You saw Luffy? Where'd he go?
Actually, I don't know. Sorry.
Jesus Christ. Well, the only next option, if you're playing this and you don't know where he's at, the only other option you're left with is the woods. Just throw that out there to you. By the way, if you have one of mine.
Wolfie! Velvet, can you walk? How's your fever?
I'm fine. I was just taking a break.
In a forest full of pickleborns? Yeah, okay.
You know better than this, Wolfie said.
Or is it pickleborns?
Running off without telling me. What if something happened to you? You wouldn't be the only one hurt. Do you understand that?
I'm sorry.
If you want to do something, just ask. I know I'm a crummy big sister, and I can't afford to buy you all the things you want.
No, that's not why I went out. You see, it was just...
I get it. You're right. I forgot the flowers for the graves.
Yeah, so I was going out to the Cape. And I thought,
you want to see the ocean too, don't you?
Well, yeah, that too.
Fine. Just for today, though.
Are you sure?
Boy, they're gonna regret that.
But next time you run off like that, I'm strapping you to your bed.
Yes, ma'am.
Alright, what I was saying before
it's
is...
off to the Cape, then.
Hooray!
If you notice in the top right side of the map,
remember how we went out together?
You'll see
the
star that tells you where you're going
next. Selica's funeral?
Yeah. I was only four, but I remember. We couldn't find any in the village or at the Cape.
Right. Because the demons had made a mess of them. And then you suddenly started climbing down the edge of the cliff.
You ran over and grabbed me. You had the scariest look on your face.
Of
course I do.
Oh, he says it with a smile on his face.
Do you have any idea what I'd do if I lost you too? You'd still have Arthur. He'd help you.
Yeah.
He'll help the world. He's quite the guy. That's probably true. But I'd still miss you like you wouldn't believe. I know. I'm sorry, sis. But down the cliff from where you were, a lone pair of Princessia were blooming. I remember. A gentle breeze came in, and it smelled like Celica. That's right. That's why I believe those flowers were a message from her. Do you know what Princessia flowers signify?
Dumb people.
An irreplaceable treasure, and wishes for good health for many years to come. Right. And that sums up my feelings nicely, Luffy. Yeah.
Aww.
Me too, sis.
Yeah, but if you see a little star on the right-hand side of the map, that's the indication where you gotta go next. I've been playing Tales of Heart R, whatever it's called, on my PS Vita, so I'm a little awkward right now trying to fight. Which, you're wondering what that game's like, it's kind of like a sped-up version of a Tales game.
How about I make you some apple boo when we get home, Luffy? Apple boo? What's that? Grated apples. Whenever I caught a cold when I was little, Celica would make it for me. It's sweet and tart and juicy and crisp. Eating it always made me feel better. Well, apples are good for you. But what does the boo mean?
Mm-hmm.
When I was a baby, I would always say boo-boo when I wanted to eat an apple. So that's where the name comes from. Wait, you called apples boo-boo? You must have been a strange baby. You used to do the same thing. When Celica and I heard you, we laughed so hard. Boo!
I kind of did the same thing when I was a kid. I used to have a word called Totally Dough. That used to symbolize anything I wanted to eat. Like, if I wanted a hug, anything. Totally Dough. I don't know where the hell I came up with that phrase. You know, whatever.
Is that all?
Alright, let's see. Well, I don't understand. Like, you can get an ability you can learn from an equipment that marks all the treasure chests on the map. I think it's either equipment or Envenomite or whatever it's called, which we'll get into that later on down the game. Yeah, there's a lot of different, I would say customizations, there's a lot of different branches in this game that you wouldn't see right off the bat when you first play through, when you first, like, introduce yourself. Like, my Let's Plays I did on the demo, I was just not even barely scratching the surface of the mechanics of this game. Which I always love. I love when I'm playing a game and I find out something new. Where are we at? Here. Because it always surprises me. Especially in games like this. Alright.
Just look at all these.
I know, girl.
This place never changes, does it? It does too change. The seasons, the wind, the weather. Change one and the sea's totally different. And the same goes for what lies across the sea. Across the sea? Sometimes I just don't know what you're talking about. Hey, Velvet. Thank you for taking me out here today. You don't need to thank me. Hey, Luffy. Do you know why it is that birds fly?
So you get shit in your cars when you're driving down the highway?
They couldn't catch food. Or escape from predators. Thought so. But you know, I think there's more to it than that. A bird that's born with wings has to... A demon!
Holy shit, it's a demon. Cool looking little son of a bitch, too.
Luffy said, run! No matter how much it hurts, run! Velvet!
It's morphin' time!
Don't be scared. You can do
sorry,
it.
I had to do that. Just don't judge me, shut up.
Like Arthur. No, you can't! Don't let your feelings get in the way, or the
This is a good time to explain some things. If you're wondering why I can't do any damage to this wolf thingy, then because I'm not an exorcist or a Malekith. See, if you play Tales of Zesha, you'll learn that the Shepherd, not going too far into detail, has the ability to hurt these things called demons. That's why she can't hurt anything. That's why Arthur can do it, because he's an exorcist. Ooh. Oh,
face me, demon.
He's got balls, give him that, but they're about to, like, yeah, he's about to die. Boom!
Okay.
Out the left field.
Velvet.
Oh, man, if you don't know, he bought that with the money he got from the book. The trade with the book. He wanted her to have a comb. Oh, I'm sentimental, damn it. I get mad when I saw this. I wanted to fuck that wolf up. And now this is where the game turns. The beginning cutscene kind of like, or, you know, video shows that, but. Yeah, you know, now this game's gonna turn dark as shit in about 2 seconds, so. Get ready to fight.
Scarlet Knight, what's going on? Was it all a dream? No, it wasn't!
Alright. Let's get into it. Okay. Now, when you play this part, I highly recommend to listen to exactly what I'm telling you.
What's happening?
Do not fight these. Just continue straight. You can't beat them because you're not at a point where you need to or can. So, just letting you know now, don't fight them.
Where are you?
You're all, I mean, I'm just telling you, you won't win. Don't try it. You will die. I don't know if they fight back. I try to avoid them. Now, I'm gonna try to see what I mean. Like, this is a damn near. Alright, let's see. Nope. Back, bad dog.
The village.
Fuck, they're at the safe spot. Fuck them. God damn, they killed everyone. Even that old bitch? Where's that lady at? Yeah, they must kill. Oh, they dragged her over there. Damn, no, that's not her. Yeah, it is her. Man, they wiped up. Is that her too? No, not somebody else. Jesus Christ. Yeah, I know. I was shocked too a little bit.
Don't give up. Never give up.
Don't give up. You never give. Sorry. Yeah, like I said, avoid a contact if all possible. There we go. Yeah, people say the game was slow to start up. The beginning part, like the village area, was slow to start up. For the most part, it was. I won't give up if you don't give up. Tranquil Woods. Yeah. Oh, look at that.
Arthur!
Such a happy looking moment from beneath a red moon.
Velvet!
You.
Oh, thank goodness. You kept Lonnie safe, didn't you, Arthur?
Yeah.
One more sentiment to cast off.
Velvet, run! Arthur!
Here, once, was the seal to the underworld broken. And tonight, here shall be born the power to save the world. With Lucky's life as a sacrifice.
What? What are you saying?
Remember when Celica died at the beginning of all this? Remember the thing that popped through her chest? Just think about it for a second. It'll come to you. Any minute now. Right about... I think somewhere around here. No, maybe. No, I'm wrong. Nope. Right here. This is where you'll see. Alright, little power up, little light, little shining. And... boom. Yep. Damn, that's a shame. Oh, it's fucked up.
Let him go. This is an offering to the world. Nothing can save him now.
No, no, no!
I see he will not change. Ever a slave to emotion.
The cutscenes like these are fucking badass. I wish they'd make an anime. Especially this one. Have you guys noticed in the first time this was done, one little thing came out of the ground? Not little, but really, that's a wrong hand. The other two. Look at her arm. It's changed her into what seems to be a demon. But it does something else to her too. This is by far one of the most badass female protagonists I've ever played as. It's just fucking awesome. There are two things that just happened to her. And you're about to see one of them. She can now fight demons. And she's neither a Maliki nor an exorcist. Just bear that information in mind. There you go. I mean, demons can fight demons. But her power is a little bit, you know, unique. Obviously, because she's the main character.
Aetherian.
Yeah. She's absorbing the, yeah.
Take a look around.
I'm not gonna say anything about. I mean, obviously, demons. People turn into demons, but I'm not gonna go into detail more about that until we get later on in the game. There's a reason for everything, believe it or not, in this game. They explain it very well. And so you know, the first thing she got now was the ability to fight back against the demon blight.
Do not fear. With my power as an exorcist. I, Artorias Colbrand, will end your pain.
Number two, she can see a Malakim. Only exorcists or people are in tune to the Malakim to see them. All those things like appearing in there like that, they're Malakims. They're like angels, pretty much, in a way.
Why is it that birds fly? Behold my answer. Velvet.
Arthur.
I ask no forgiveness. The sin is mine to bear.
Artoria!
And there you go. So all the jokes I've been making about how the story is going to turn dark and yeah, shit like that. Sad story. It's a deep story. I like it a lot.
I will make you pay.
On lower battle difficulties, enemies attack less frequently and with less force, making them easier to defeat. But higher difficulties offer benefits such as improved item drops from enemies. Also, some effects of Potenight only activate on certain difficulty levels. You can change battle difficulty at any time by choosing options from the system menu.
So did my world come to an end. And for 3 long years,
yeah.
I sat in that pit of darkness and fed. Devouring demons. So I could live. So I could live long enough to kill him. And be my brother's vengeance.
Yeah, 3 years locked in that prison, feeding on demons. That does great for your personality, I'm telling you. You love people so much after that. Sort of.
First, there will be a test.
Really?
It will decide if you are worth teaching.
Put the enemy to attack, then perform a sidestep. How's gonna get rid of it?
Burning wing!
love of God. Really? I didn't do it. Whatever. That's weird. If you tilt the left analog while defending with left bumper, you will perform a quick step. Quick stepping spends a small amount of soul gauge to dash in the direction pressed on left analog, and can even be performed during a combo. If you perform a quick step just before any enemy attacks, that attack will only do one damage, and you will recover some SG. Additionally, a soul may also appear. Collect it to gain one soul, which is what these are on the ground.
If you are not, I will kill you. Ready yourself.
That little circle you saw around me, when some enemies lock the, or a friendly locks a spell onto you, it'll change colors when it's about to be ready to detonate. You'll have a marker on you, which is a circle, and the enemy will have one too, which is a diamond. Just keep that in mind as you're fighting, so be aware of that situation. Now, some enemies might not use a spell that has a circle or an area of effect. Some might use like one that has a straight line of sight, which will be, you'll notice it by a line connecting you to them. That will appear on the field.
Why are you holding back?
You noticed. Well done. You pass.
Of course. His Moloch would never be so weak as that.
I am his Moloch no longer. First, let me tell you what has transpired these past 3 years. There are exorcists now throughout the land, challenging the reign of demons with the help of... Tell me. Tell me where Artorias is. You may find him in the capital city of Logris in Midgand. You won't stop to listen. I can tell you what it was you saw that night. That night, the ritual he performed shifted the very course of the world. A host of Malachim descended, and with their strength, the emergent exorcists quelled the demon tide. Now, he serves as leader of the Exorcist's Abbey, an institution that enjoys the unconditional faith of the kingdom and public. A shield to guard the people, and a sword against demons. Artorias Colbrand, the world's savior.
With power stolen by sacrificing Lafayette.
All right, so this is called Prodigy Gal. Non-martial art damage. parts. It is a dependable tactic. Belt, armor.
Effects in here. Masterpiece.
And if I can't use it, it's worthless.
True. Tell you one thing, you gotta give her credit for her fashion sense. I mean, come on, damn. I was not expecting her to look like this. I thought I'd be back to her old gear or something.
All right.
Are you ready then?
What's going on here?
No ordinary soldier. He's an exorcist orderly.
Well, he was.
You didn't even flinch.
I already told you. I am his Moloch no longer.
Is there a ship waiting?
So you already know we're on an island?
Yes. I've learned that this is a prison island for violent criminals, and that there are scores of demons locked away here. Demons say lots of things when they don't want you to eat them.
Okay.
The prison has docks at both the front and rear entrances. Our ship is on the back side.
Got it. The back docks.
Alright, let's see if I can screw around with my equipment now. Yeah, there we go. Alright. See, you can change back to her. What if you... You can unlock different attachments, like helmets and stuff, and that's what this is, hat styles. Push your hair back for that. And then there's her villager style. And then this is her different gear, so yeah. For me, I have not unlocked any other really, like, different suits in this game, besides some Norman outfits, which you'll eventually come across at yourself, but I haven't seen anything crazy. Or anything like the awesome gear. As far as changing of looks, so. Alright, well, I'm gonna end it here just because I don't wanna get too far ahead and take forever to upload. Tranquil Woods, there you go. So we're out of the Tranquil Woods and now we're on Titania, the island prison. So, our next playthrough will be breaking out of jail. Woo! Never thought I'd say that. Thanks for stopping by, guys. This is Game Flunkie, signing off.